Hi, it's Darren and Chris from Martin Deerline. Today we're going to show you guys a little bit of moisture meter maintenance. Things that you need to do to keep your moisture meter working on your combine, on your yield and moisture system. So Chris is going to show us, first of all, we're going to pull the pins out of there and pull the auger out. That's something that you should be doing on a regular basis, because believe it or not, in conditions like we have a tendency sometimes to get some dirt in that, in our moisture meter. So this is the auger that carries the material back into the return side of the clean grain elevator as after the moisture meter has sampled it and putting it back into the clean grain elevator. A lot of times you can take this out and this will be half full of dirt. Notice that there is a drive pin on the top, so when Chris slides this up, he'll go up the rod that's up there, turn this in place, and then put this puppy in there. As he's doing that, it's pretty simple, but if you've never done it before, just notice how he's doing that with his bottom finger, getting that pin in there in place.
There we go.
Like so. And then he's going to put the pins in. Then he's going to go up top to the wing nut on the proximity sensor, and he's going to take the proximity sensor loose, and there's a cleaning that can be done on the plate of the proximity sensor. A lot of times this thing can get gummed up, and of course then it doesn't read properly. Do not clean this with emery cloth or brake cleaner or anything like that. The correct cleaner to use for this is glass cleaner. Be careful with it, it's half fragile. So those are a couple of things that need to be done. That's regular maintenance on your moisture meter for your moisture meter to be accurate. There's one more calibration on the moisture meter that we do in the cab of the combine, and we'll go through that with you shortly. Okay, so now we're in the cab. We've let the screen boot up. So we're in the cab, we want to do our moisture meter temperature calibration. So we're going to hit the book, go in here. Of course, you can scroll through. We are at moisture sensor temperature calibration. You can run through all the different ones that we're at there, right? So moisture temperature calibration, again, we're going to go in there. This is pretty darn simple. Basically, it tells you what the temperature that the sensor is saying it is right now. So what we do, you want to do this with the combine when you're starting out for the day, when the combine isn't affected by the temperature of the combine, the heat from the machine, etc. So it's a good idea to do this at the start of the day. This is not something you have to do consistently all the time. You just have to stop and check and verify once in a while that it is correct. So right now it says the temperature sensor is 8 degrees Celsius. What a guy would do is you'd use your iPhone, check and see what the actual temperature is, and if the temperature is out, let's say that it was 12 degrees Celsius and the temperature sensor is saying it's 8 degrees Celsius. Our offset that we'd put in there then, we'd want to put an offset in there of 4, because 8 plus 4 equals 12. Look at that, I can even count. So that 12 degrees Celsius, so now we've adjusted the meter, so that is correct. If you think about that, that's one of the things. What are the things that you do when you're sampling your grain at home, when you're testing with your tester? You're measuring the moisture in it and you're checking to see what the temperature of the grain is. Well, this is the temperature of the grain part. So it's probably a pretty important part, right, when you're wanting accuracy in your from your moisture meter. Just FYI, in 2020, Deere has gone to the point that we don't have to do this anymore and the machine does it automatically. But for anybody who is not running a brand new machine, this is something that you have to do on all your S-Series combines.